acting can be quite an interesting profession, all things considered. Throwing yourself into a role, embodying a character completely, it's something that takes true talent and drive. Two things that Pennywise himself, Bill Skarsgard, has in spades. However, acting can also be an unexpectedly dangerous craft, with characters sometimes leaving lasting impact on an actor's psyche. Sure, acting isn't dangerous like being a soldier or deep sea welder or lion tamer, but it's a different kind of dangerous, especially when the character is as out there and fully realized as Pennywise. And Pennywise definitely has left its mark on Skarsgard in ways you might not expect. Not quite sure what we mean? Well, keep watching and you'll find out how Pennywise has changed Skarsgard's life. Pennywise the Dancing Clown is quite the landmark role for Bill Skarsgård. While the 29-year-old actor already had quite the acting resume before taking on the role, his part in it certainly made him a much more recognizable figure in the industry, making him about as well known as his other family members who also work in the same field, Stellan, his father, and Alexander, his brother. So of course, if we wanted to cop out here and talk about how Pennywise affected his life in an external sense, pointing out the massive bump in his career prospects would be the way to go. And it certainly was a big change for Skarsgård, but if you dig a bit deeper, there are some pretty sizable internal changes as well. Skarsgård has said publicly that when he auditions for a role in a film, he doesn't do a ton of prep work, trying not to get too attached to the role. However, once he gets the part, all bets are off, and he dives headfirst into the character, trying his best to embody it completely. Now, this is particularly noteworthy because Skarsgård doesn't exactly pick roles that are, let's say, all that cheerful. The two roles that he's perhaps best known for outside of Pennywise, for example, are as Roman Godfrey, a vampire, on Netflix's Hemlock Grove, and Henry Deaver on Castle Rock, another Stephen King-inspired property. That last role, by the way, is the one that is theorized by many fans of the show to be a devil in disguise. Literally, people think the character is actually the devil, like Satan himself. So yeah, not really any wholesome stuff there if you catch our drift. So diving completely into a role like those is bound to mess with your head, and it seems things were no different for Pennywise. Skarsgård has portrayed the character now for two films. It, now retroactively known as It Chapter 1 in 2017, and It Chapter 2 in 2019. So a fairly sizable chunk of time. And apparently, Pennywise is not an easy role to walk away from when the cameras were done rolling. Skarsgård told Entertainment Weekly a short while ago that the realization that he didn't have to deal with the character, and his relationship to it anymore, hit him suddenly while spending time with his mother at his childhood home. He said, quote, "It was a very quick shift of just feeling better. Like, oh my god, I'm relieved that I don't have to deal with the darkness of the character." Skarsgård actually compared the realization to a sort of exorcism, with the evil of the character leaving him. But things don't seem to have really been all that easy, as shortly after that, the nightmares began. Like the children in the film, it would seem that Pennywise really had it out for Skarsgård, haunting him when he should have felt the safest, when he was asleep. The actor reported that he began to have some extremely vivid dreams of the character. Some nights, he was Pennywise again himself. Others, he was merely with the demonic clown. Skarsgård said, quote, "Every night he came and visited. It was in the shape of either me dealing with him, sort of Pennywise as a separate entity of me, and then also me as Pennywise in circumstances that I didn't appreciate. Like, I'm Pennywise and I'm really upset that I'm out in public and people are looking at me." However, even these seemingly twisted visions, something that many of us would probably find absolutely horrifying, were something that the actor took in stride, stating that ultimately it was something that he enjoyed. Quote, "And then I wake up and I'm like, that was kind of sweet. This was a process of letting go of the monster." Now that right there is the kind of thing that only an actor would say, specifically about a character that they had spent 4+ years working to craft and make a part of themselves. One has to wonder though if Skarsgård has fully managed to decouple himself from the dancing clown entirely, or if it is something that is always going to be a part of who he is. At the very least, movie fans will forever know him as the scariest clown around, right up there with Tim Curry's version of the character. Man, having Pennywise haunt your dreams has got to be a horrible thing to deal with. Though to Skarsgård's credit, he seems to enjoy it more than you would expect. How would you handle seeing Pennywise in your dreams every night? Let us know down in the comments below, and while you're down there, why not hit that subscribe button and ring the bell so you can be notified when we upload more great videos just like this one. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you at the movies. Just be careful not to look directly into the deadlights, okay?